bacterial motility. This particular test can be done in two ways. Now we'll discuss about how to do the bacterial motility by using a motility tube. This particular tube has got a semi-solid media, meaning that it is a little bit watery. So what we try to do, we try to take the bacteria of our interest and try to see whether it is motile or not. So we pick the bacteria by using a loop and try to inoculate in the middle of the media. It's basically a stabbing procedure. Do not stab till the end of the tube. So we take the bacteria, stab it into the tube, and we wait till the next day, try to see whether the bacteria has moved from the place of inoculum to the other sides of the tube. This will demonstrate the motility in a tube. Thank you. Let's see how we do it. This experiment will try to demonstrate the motility of the bacteria in the plate A and in the plate B. The plate A has E. coli and plate B has Staphylococcus aureus. So it's very obvious, the plate A is a motile bacteria, the plate B is a non-motile bacteria. This bacteria got flagella and this one is a cocci, they don't have any flagella. So let's try to see whether this bacteria really moves or not. So this is a straight loop. If you try to see this particular loop, it doesn't have any ring in the top. We are going to use this to inoculate the bacteria for motility in a motility tubes. Okay, before starting the experiment, I mark the tube A and B. So A is for E. coli and B is for Staphylococcus aureus. We'll try to pick the colony from here and inoculate into the tube. And we'll pick the colony from here and inoculate into this tube B. So we'll try to pick the colony by using the straight loop. Pick the colony. You can see the colony is being picked on this particular loop. And then I take the motility media A, it matches with this. Open it up near the flame and straight away put it inside. And this is what we call stabbing. So you can see the loop, but do not touch the bottom of the tube. Do not touch the bottom of the tube and slowly take it out. Okay. Then cap the tube. Now the bacteria is inoculated inside the tube. Right. In the same way, we try to take the plate B and try to inoculate into the motility media B. I'll pick the colony from plate B and the bacteria is being picked and we'll try to inoculate into the tube B. Stab it, it goes inside, leave the bacteria there, come out. This is done. So we have to incubate it for about overnight and then we'll come and see the results the next day. Okay, now you can see that both the tubes, tube A, the bacteria has grown everywhere. Not only in the inoculum, the bacteria has grown everywhere. So this is a motile bacteria, E. coli. Whereas for case of Staph aureus, this particular bacteria has not grown anywhere from the place of inoculum. So this is a non-motile bacteria and this is a motile bacteria. So the E. coli is a motile bacteria. So this is a motile bacteria. And this is a non-motile bacteria, which is Staph aureus. You don't see the bacterial growth away from the place of inoculum. In the contrary, you can see the E. coli has grown across all the medium. So when you try to compare this both, you can see the turbidity in this particular plate, in this particular tube, and no turbidity in this tube for Staphylococcus aureus. Hope this is clear for motility. Thank you.